The newest ocean ship in Viking Cruises fleet, Viking Jupiter, offers a variety of cruises to Northern Europe and the Mediterranean. A replica of its five sister ships, this vessel also features amenities similar to what you would find on Viking Cruises river ships. The Princess and I have just returned from 8 nights on board this newly minted ship, and we have plenty to report. I'm DB from EatSleepCruise.com, and in this video, we give you our honest review of Viking Jupiter. Embarkation was a bit different than we are accustomed to with larger ships. It occurred in a tent located in front of the vessel, as there was no terminal in our departure port of Stockholm, Sweden. Still, we were from the bus transfer, check-in, and on board with a glass of champagne within 15 minutes. For this trip, there was no tendering involved. We docked at all 5 ports, and getting on and off the ship was effortless and well organized. Procedures were like any other cruise ship, with security processing passengers on and off the vessel. Our media group departed halfway through the Viking Homelands cruise, so disembarkation was slightly different for us. Therefore, it's difficult to rate the typical passenger experience for disembarkation. As this was a cold water cruise, with a very busy itinerary, we did not spend any time in the pools or hot tubs. Still, for a ship of this size, the pool deck was more than sufficient. The midship pool on deck 7 had a retractable roof, which remained closed for our entire trip. Therefore, any day could be a pool day on a Viking Ocean cruise. After the ship, there was also an infinity pool. Honestly, it was a bit smaller than we expected, but it did provide another option for sun worshippers to get some rays and amazing aft views. Of note, the thermal suite is also complimentary for all guests on Viking cruises. There, you'll find an additional therapy pool to provide you even more options for taking a dip. We will preface this by saying we did not have high expectations for the sports deck on a Viking Ocean cruise. Unlike larger cruise ships with full sports courts or other amenities like a rock climbing wall or ropes course, the small outdoor sports area on deck 9 offers some relaxing pastimes. Among them are a putting green, lawn bowling, table tennis, and of course, shuffleboard. Given the clientele, as well as the line's focus on destinations, these additional activities are a nice touch to break up your day, weather permitting. A jogging and walking track is also located on deck 2 and circles most of the ship, offering another outdoor option for some cardio. Yes, you would expect friendly and attentive service on a luxury cruise ship. Still, the team on Viking Jupiter were the most personable and responsive crew staff we've probably ever had in over 30 cruises. No matter the venue or department, staff were always smiling and eager to help. There were several bar servers who remembered our names, even when we didn't remember them. They were always quick to take our order and ask us about our day. Though, service in the main dining room did resemble more of a mainstream cruise line, with longer wait times and staff appearing rushed. Our stateroom attendant Jackie was also excellent. She referred to us by name from day one and was like a ninja making up our room no matter what time left in the morning or headed out for dinner. There was only one sea day during the 8 days we were on board the ship. Still, when compared to contemporary cruise lines, there were less daytime activities occurring. As part of the cruise fare, Viking Ocean Cruises includes one complimentary tour at each port of call. These tours were often bus tours or walking tours of the city centers. If you consider this part of the daily activities, then it's a win. While somewhat limited, Viking Ocean Cruisers can still find enjoyable ways to spend their days. While normally an upcharge on other ships, the spa's thermal suite is complimentary and open every day. On board, there were 3 lecturers, a historian, a cultural expert, and even an astronomer who was a rocket scientist. The individuals gave talks on various subject matters during the day and early evening. Unfortunately, we never attended one as we were so busy ashore. Unique to Viking Jupiter, there's also the Explorer's Dome, which is a planetarium offering 3 different shows. We highly recommend checking them all out. Probably the only place where we felt the Viking Jupiter did not surpass other cruise lines was the main dining room. The restaurant on deck 2 offered a nightly menu, often featuring a small selection of regional specialties. Of course, there was also the classic menu, including your typical steak, chicken, and salmon options, as well as other items that changed each evening. In our opinion, the food was on par with meals you find on much larger vessels, with the lobster being one of the standout exceptions. We did set the bar higher for the ship, but we found the main dining room was no better than our experiences with other cruise lines. The three times we dined at this venue, we were there for quite a long time, and we felt the venue was understaffed. On the other hand, the two specialty restaurants on Viking Jupiter, Manfredi's and Chef's Table, are certainly worthy upgrades to the main dining room. Both of these specialty restaurants are included in the price of the cruise fare, with no additional upcharges. Though reservations are required, our two dinners at Manfredi's were excellent. The venue delivered authentic, homemade Italian food that we expect from a high-end restaurant in the north end of Boston. Among the standouts were the freshly made bread, pasta, and the massive chicken parmesan. The Chef's Table offers a 5-course tasting menu with up to 5 different menus throughout the cruise. We only dined here once for the Cruisian menu. Each course was well executed, and the chef was more than happy to accommodate the princess's picky taste. He created variations to the starters and a chicken entree option for her. The crispy prawns and the wok-fried beef were among my favorites. If we were on the full cruise, we would definitely have returned here for one of the other themed evenings, knowing that the venue was willing to accommodate our food preferences. While the main dining room was pretty typical, the various casual options on the ship were worthy of multiple visits. In many aspects, Viking Ocean Cruises focus on quality over quantity, where you will probably have more casual dining options on larger ships with varying quality of taste and preparation. The fewer casual venues on Viking Jupiter delivered every single time. The World Cafe on Deck 7 is a cruise buffet with some upscale food options. Each day and night, the menu provided plenty of different meats, pastas, and seafood that surpassed this New Englander's expectations. In fact, I found myself eating more seafood on this trip than I ever eat on a cruise. The Viking Bar served snacks throughout the day, which included open-faced sandwiches, breakfast pastries, and cookies that were hard to resist when ordering coffee. Other casual food options include the Pool Grill, with freshly made burgers, and Mamsons, with lighter fare, including some amazing custom waffles. The food at these venues was always fresh and well-prepared. Unlike the ships that we typically sail on, which are destinations themselves, Viking ships are the backdrop to the ports of call you visit during your cruise. Still, the cruise director Heather and her assistant Ian did provide some nightly entertainment that was pretty standard for a cruise. These activities include some aforementioned lecturers, as well as port talks that featured background for the upcoming stops. In the main theater on Deck 2, there is one headliner act. This comedian magician had a British sense of humor and was surprisingly entertaining. The ship also featured a quartet of Viking singers and some production shows that were pretty standard, including a tribute to ABBA. Other entertainment included an Elvis tribute by the assistant cruise director and some jaw-dropping opera by the cruise director Heather. Like most cruise ships, there were also musical acts that played regularly in the different venues. Among them was a solo pianist and a cello and violin duo that tended to play in either the atrium or the Explorer's Lounge. Featured performers included the Viking band and the acoustic guitarist Matthew. He was by far our favorite performer on the ship and ranks way up there with other favorite cruise ship musicians. This 48,000 gross ton ship is outfitted with 7 bars, featuring mostly the same drink menu. Drinks are pretty typical cocktails like martinis, mixed drinks, and long drinks to keep everyone happy. Of course, you can still get a frozen pina colada or a daiquiri if you want. Unique to Viking Ocean is the Winter Garden. This venue hosts afternoon tea with an assortment of light bites. We thought this was a nice touch, but felt the venue could be open more. Given that it's a decent sized space and has a bar, it did seem underutilized. Finally, the only venue with a distinct specialty cocktail menu is the nightclub Torshaven. This venue is the late night scene with champagne cocktails. At all the bars and lounges, there was plenty of staff and drink service was prompt. Our go-to spots were the Viking Bar in the morning for espresso or a midday drink, and the Explorer's Lounge in Torshaven in the evenings. We'd stayed in a deluxe veranda stateroom, a D2 category. The balcony was a good size with two chairs and a table that was perfect for watching the sunset or sunrise. Other nice upgrades to the typical cruise ship cabin were the oversized showers, heated floors in the bathroom, and the several outlets and USB ports on the desk near the bed. Viking Ocean Cruises provides premium shower products that are regularly replaced by your stateroom attendant. We felt the accommodations were comfortable, but no bigger than staterooms on larger cruise ships. The decor was stylish yet functional. We had just enough storage between the closet and drawers for our 8 nights. Overall, the cabin was well appointed and familiar, which was perfect for us. With only 900 passengers on board and long days ashore, it often feels like you have the entire ship to yourself. The only time we experienced any crowds was during peak times at the buffet. Besides that, there were virtually no lines at any of the venues. Getting a table at the restaurant was never a problem. Bar service was fast, and getting morning coffee or evening cocktails never took more than a few minutes. Getting seats at the talks and the nighttime shows was not an issue either. Embarkation and getting on and off the ship at the ports of call was also quick and efficient. Viking appears to do a great job dispersing crowds and providing an enjoyable and stress-free atmosphere for all. Our departure port was Stockholm, Sweden. On day one, we arrived and were able to check into the ship and then explore the city on our own, spending most of our day in Skansen, the outdoor museum. Spending the night in Stockholm, on day two, we did the included bus tour with Viking Cruises. This bus tour lasted approximately 2 hours. And then we spent some time on our own, doing a self-guided tour of the old town, as well as watching the changing of the guard before catching the last shuttle back to the ship. On day three, we stopped in Helsinki. Again, in the morning, we did one of the included bus tours. Among the highlights was Sibelius Monument, as well as a stop near the Olympic Stadium. After the bus tour, we did our own self-walking tour of some of the major city highlights, including the Rock Church and the Contemporary Art Museum, before catching one of the last buses back to the ship. Days 4 and 5 were in St. Petersburg, Russia. Here, we paid for one of the most premium shore excursions, a 2-day itinerary that hit most of the major highlights of the city. Among them were the Hermitage Museum, Catherine's Palace, the Peterhof Palace, as well as a trip to the Russian Ballet. Our tour guide, Sasha, who we spent 2 days with, was amazing, and this 2-day itinerary was by far the highlight of our cruise. On day 6, we stopped in Tallinn, Estonia. Here, we did the included walking tour of the medieval old town. We could have spent all day in this charming and quaint area, exploring the cobblestone streets and viewing the 14th century historic walls. Our tour guide was a wealth of information, and after our guided tour, we spent a couple more hours in the beautiful sun exploring on our own. For our stop in Gdansk, Poland, we also did a guided walking tour through Viking. Our tour guide, Peter, who also happened to be a local police officer, was also great, and he brought us around the historic area to stops like St. Mary's Church, the Neptune Fountain, and the Golden Gate. Unfortunately, the ship had a dock at a city that was about 30 minutes away from Gdansk, so we did not have as much free time as we would have liked to explore on our own. Our last stop was in Germany. The group we were traveling with were bused to Berlin, and we spent the day exploring the city. Here, we booked a private walking tour with original Berlin walks. The 4-hour Discover Berlin walking tour was amazing. Our tour guide, Sam, did a great job of taking us to all of the city's highlights while describing their rich history and providing a unique perspective at all these memorable sites, including the Berlin Wall, Museum Island, and other memorable stops throughout the city. He was hands down one of the best tour guides we have ever experienced. And there you have it. That's our honest review of a Viking ocean cruise on Viking Jupiter. But of course, we'd love to hear from you. Let us know in the comment section below if you've ever cruised on a Viking ocean cruise and give us your review. I'm DB from eatsleepcruise.com. And if you enjoyed this video, we'd really appreciate it if you gave it a big thumbs up. If you haven't already done so, what are you waiting for? Make sure to subscribe to the channel and hit that notification icon. That way you get updated when we put out brand new videos. You can also hit us up all over social media at Eat Sleep Cruise. and thanks again for watching.